it's always a feisty game, this one, and this game was absolutely no difference.
Yeah, definitely. It was, like I say, it's almost like a local derby, even though it's not very local. But, you know, with the derbies from last year, it's carried on into tonight, really. I thought it was a well sort of tempered game, even though it was physical and demanding, and, you know, two competitive teams, you know, and they're top of the league. You can see why. You know, they're a very competitive team, and we had to stand up to that tonight, and I thought the boys did. I thought it was a great away performance from us, and, you know, I thought we were good for the point.
Played well to earn that point in the end. You had to take your time within the game, because Woking liked to be on front most of it, and in the end you kept pushing, and when Torquay had the opportunity to take Caesar advantage, they took it with that goal.
Yeah, exactly. We dominated spells, as did they, but it was a good performance from the lads. A good away performance. They had to dig in at times, and Woking do put you under that pressure, and we had to stand up to that when they're putting balls in the box from throw-ins, from free kicks, from corners. I thought we give away too many free kicks, you know, in and around the box, which, you know, they're good at and played into their hands a little bit, but we had to stand up to that, and I thought the back four and, you know, everyone else that was in there defended well, got their head on it, and the goalkeeper had done his job when he had to, so it was really good. It was a good goal from them in the end, a good strike from the lad to get them the lead, but, you know, it was good play from us in the end, a quick throw and a great delivery from Wince in the far post, and Whitfield with a header at the far post. I'm not sure he scored many of them, but, you know, it's great for him on his debut to come in, and he's only just signed, signed today, but we had him in the building yesterday, so, you know, for him to come on, and he came on a little bit earlier, that, you know, like, just shows how competitive it was with losing two players in the first half. We had to make changes, and the boys dealt with that well. And we ended up, like I say, getting a really good point, you know, at the top of the league, and they're flying and doing really well, and they won six in a row. So for us to take 2 points off them and come away from a point away from home is really good. It's just now that we've got to back that up the weekend.
You talk about two players coming off in the game, Armine Little and Conor Lemon-Havens. It was quite obvious there was an injury to Armine Little, but was there an injury as well to Conor Lemon-Havens? And what's the update on the injury to Armine?
Yeah, we've still got, obviously, to get him assessed in the next couple of days, but Armine's, you know, looked almost precautionary. It was, you know, he was feeling his hamstring, but we felt we didn't want it to go, if you know what I mean. So we've still got to see what it is, and then it's an ankle injury to Conor, so we've still got to see how bad that is. But, you know, we'll get them assessed tomorrow in the morning and see where we're at. But, you know, like I say, they come off, but the lads who had to come on did themselves well. They're proud. They did a good job, and like I say, it's a tough place to come when they're on form like they are, and, you know, the crowd get going, and, you know, they put you under pressure. So really proud of the lads, how they've you know, stood up to it.
As well, Joe Lewis, he seemed to be pulling, I think it was a hamstring towards the end. Any update on that one at all?
Yeah, he's fine. I think it was just cramp in the end, so I don't think he's any dramas for the weekend. I think he's come through that game well, and I thought for him to come into a hostile place, you know, and with balls that are coming into the box, he's dealt with it well. So it's a great learning experience for him, and, you know, he's done a good job tonight.
Two players I'll also touch on now, Ben Whitfield, who you just mentioned, only making his debut today, and Manny Duku, only his second ever start for Torquay, but seemed like he's been playing for Torquay for years, the way he was playing, running everywhere throughout the whole game.
Yes. Yeah, well, we knew we could sort of release Dukes down our right, and, you know, get the ball to him and sort of unleash him to sort of just use them sprints and that power and that energy that he's got, and he did that, you know, perfectly tonight. You know, he played to the game plan well. So, but let's say, you know, and Ben on the left, you know, when he had to come on, and done a good job. So, but let's say everyone tonight put in an unbelievable effort, and you know, at times our quality might not have been there, and we're a little bit frustrating with we could have punished them a bit more, you know, and we didn't have that final pass or final end product that we'd like. But as far as commitment and determination away from home, we can't ask for much more than that. And, you know, like I say, a great away point, great away performance. And now we're just, like I say, again, we need to win. We need to back that up on Saturday now with 3 points, and this will make this an even better point.
Finally, going on to that game on Saturday, Harrogate, who seemed to be the surprise package last season in the National League. The game's come thick and fast. How are you going to prepare the boys for that one?
Prepare like we have done. I mean, we've had you know, it's was that 9 games now in nearly a month, you know. So, you know, it's 8 games in August, that's the first one in September. So it's, you know, it's preparing like we have done every other game. We'll get the lads ready, recovered, you know, get them organised. You know, we've been looking at Harrogate for the last couple of days, so we know what to expect, and see how they've done tonight, and then we'll, you know, we'll prepare like we always do throughout the week, moving on to Saturday, and you know, we'll make sure the lads are all in, and that, you know, they'll be in good spirits after that. You know, they're quite happy with what they've done there. You know, the determination that they've come through that at the top of the league. So yeah, all in all, I think it's been a good night. You know, it could have been a little bit better with 3 points, obviously, but stating the obvious there. But no, all in all, it was a good performance from the lads.